They say that you only fall in love once in a lifetime. I mean, really in love. The kind of love where butterflies dance in your stomach and you're weak in the knees. I've been there. It started off as the worst day of my life. A total disaster. But then, there he was. My knight in shining armor. My hero. It was love at first sight. Just like in a fairy tale. His name was Daniel. We were made for each other. A picture-perfect couple. Our lives were complete. Nothing could ever be better than this. Or so I thought. When Lily and Emma were born, we fell in love all over again. We were overjoyed. My sweet, shy Lily and Emma, who knew what she wanted and how to get it. They were fraternal twins, and they were as different as night and day. From the time they were little girls, they loved to play matchmaker. Valentine's Day was their favorite day of the whole year. They made cute little Valentine cards and delivered them to the neighborhood. My cute, funny girls. They were always trying to help someone fall in love and live happily ever after. But doesn't happily ever after only happen in fairy tales?
I'm gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you too.
I don't wanna go.
Can't just let her go. Dad, you have to go after her. Bye.
Parting is such sweet sorrow. That I shall say goodnight till it be morrow.
Sleep dwell upon thy eyes, peace in thy breast. Were I to sleep in peace, so sweet to rest, hence will I to my ghostly father's cell, his help to crave and my dear hap to tell.
Thank you. Thank you. Lily, that was beautiful. Elliot, you've done better. Let's try this scene again, and this time I want you a little closer, and I want you to really feel it. I want to feel the emotion of this scene. If you get the part of Juliet, you can't be shy.
I know. Good night, good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night till it be morrow.
Sleep dwell upon thy eyes, peace in thy breast. Were I to sleep in peace so sweet to rest, hence will I to my ghostly father's cell, his help to crave and my dear hap to tell.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. You may have a seat. Let's go back to the beginning of scene 9.
Nice job, Lily.
Looks like I'm gonna have some competition this year.
Thanks, Megan. Did you know that Juliet was only 13 when she married Romeo?
No, I didn't. And ew.
It's so romantic.
It's so illegal.
I understand that the language of Shakespeare can be difficult to understand, but we have a rule in this class that we all stay awake. Barry, why don't you come up here and read with me? I'll be Juliet. Scene nine.
We have an emergency.
Another one?
He jests at scars that never felt a wound, but soft what light through yonder window breaks. It is the east, and Juliet is the sun.
So what's going on?
Marvin wants to ask Rita out, but he doesn't know how to do it. Okay, where is she?
Do you think she'd go out with me?
Of course she will. As long as you ask her out in the right way. I mean, you can't just go up to her and be like, yo, Rita, wanna go out?
That's what her ex-boyfriend Tyler did.
And that's why he's her ex-boyfriend. Girls like it when you use romantic words.
Like what?
Here, connect this to your phone and put the earbud in. I'll be on the other line and tell you exactly what to say. What's your number?
It's 555-0958.
Okay, she's alone. Now's your chance.
Okay, Marvin, can you hear me?
Hello? Hello?
Put your phone in your pocket.
Hey, Rita.
You're in my light. Tell her that her eyes are like sapphires.
Your eyes are like sapphires.
What?
And your lips are like rubies.
And your lips are like rubies.
Are you being serious? She's never gonna go for that.
Just quiet.
No, Marvin, not you.
Tell her that her skin reminds you of the most delicate porcelain.
Your skin is like the most delicate porcelain.
You think so?
And you'd walk over 1,000 miles
of hot coals just to be able to touch that skin.
I'd walk 1,000 miles over hot coals just to spend one small moment with you.
That's kind of sweet. See, he's getting it. And that if she'd let you take her to the movie Saturday night,
Poop.
Marvin? Hello, Marvin?
Do you want to go to the movie Saturday night?
Sure. Pick me up at 6.
My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself, because it is an enemy to thee.
Art thou not Romeo and a Montague? Thank you, Barry. Emma, tell me, why does Juliet say, my only love sprung from my only hate?
Because when Juliet finds out that Romeo is a Montague, she realizes that even though it's her true love, he's her worst enemy.
Thank you, Lily. I have another rule in my class, and that is that you remain in your seats for the entire class period. To the principal's office, please.
Cutting class is never acceptable.
But it was an emergency.
For whatever reason. I called your parents.
Why?
How many times have you been in my office this year?
3?
25.
Is that your lovely wife? She's really pretty. What's her favorite flower? I'm sure it's Narcissus. When was the last time you sent her flowers? She looks like the kind of woman who adores getting flowers.
Wait outside my office. Your parents will be here soon.
Yes?
Miss Adams, please order me some flowers.
What kind?
Narcissus.
It wasn't our fault.
He wouldn't listen.
I'll handle it.
Mrs. Valentine.
Miss.
Come in, please.
One down and one to go. Hi, Dad. She's already in there.
I'll get right to the point. We pride ourselves in being supportive and tolerant of our students. We want them to feel good about themselves and to have a healthy self-esteem. I have a goal for each of our students, that they leave this school a better person.
How long is this gonna take?
As long as it needs to. What happened?
They cut class.
You mean to tell me you've never cut class? Not even once?
It's the third time this week. As I was saying, I would like each and every one of our students.
What did you say?
Nothing. Nothing, I...
Yes, you did. You always do that. Why do you always do that?
They're fighting.
What else is new?
Attention, all students. That Sadie Hawkins dance is in 2 weeks. Get your dates.
We'll need to design new dresses,
hairstyles,
shoes,
makeup,
manicures,
pedicures. Hey, Jamie.
Oh, hey, Melissa.
Adam Jones. Okay, you got it.
Scott Tucker, are you sure?
Hey, Liz.
Oh, okay, bye.
Nice choice. Okay, bye.
Hello?
Sounds good. Oh, bye, gotta go.
What am I gonna do with you two? Be good. Come on.
Call me later.
Okay, bye.
Let's go.
Not there. So, why don't you tell me what was so important you had to cut class?
You're not gonna buy it anyway, so why bother?
Try me.
This kid in school today was like, I really want to ask this girl out, but I don't know how. And I was like, oh, you should just...
Okay, you're doing that on purpose to bug me. Start over, try it again, this time in English.
Okay, well, we're in drama class and we got a text from Marvin. Oh, sorry. Hello? Yeah, I was thinking Peter would be perfect for you. I know he looks good, right? He lost like 55 pounds on some veggie sandwich diet. Yeah, okay, bye. Anyway, Marvin wanted to ask Reed out, but he's totally lacking in the romance department. So we had to sort of tutor him. He was pretty desperate, but you know how guys are.
Yeah. I guess I do.
Hello? Hey, Sophie. Yes, he's still available. No, I won't forget. Okay, bye. Hey, Dad, can we go riding after dinner?
I can't. I really gotta get this work done. It's important.
So why couldn't you just wait and help Marvin out after school?
Love won't wait, Mom. Did you know Juliet was only 13 when she married Romeo? She didn't wait. She went for it. She followed her heart.
Yeah, and look what happened to her.
At least she tasted true love, if only for a moment.
Mm-hmm. But I bet she'd think twice if she had to do it over again.
Mrs. Porter, she's holding auditions for Romeo and Juliet. And I really want to be Juliet. But every time I audition for her, I get really tongue-tied. And I'll probably just blow it, and Megan will get the lead just like she did last year.
Mm-mm. You would be a perfect Juliet.
You think so?
I know so.
Thanks.
Hello? Yeah, I'm having a pool party at my house tomorrow after school. Everyone's invited.
Okay, we'll finalize things then. Bye.
Pool party? When were you gonna ask me? You should be grounded for today's escapade.
I know, Dad. I'm sorry.
You still want to go riding?
Yes.
Well, sorry lately. I've been,
grumpy, moody.
Yeah, all that. So, what would you think if I sold my business?
Thought you loved what you did.
I used to. I think that's what got your mom so upset. So wrapped up in it.
Just a little.
Well, I got a guy who's interested in buying it. He's supposed to call me in a couple of days.
That'd be really cool.
Think your mom would come back if I sold it?
Maybe. Want a race?
You're on.
Gosh, for real? Next.
I don't want anyone with zits, smelly pits, or halitosis.
Oh, you guys totally rock. Oh, I'm in heaven.
Are you sure? He's so not who I had in mind.
Trust us. He's perfect for you.
Okay. What about Raymond Taylor?
No.
Paul Richardson?
No.
Casey Childs?
No.
Okay, Howard likes science and mathematics, dislikes English, strengths, strong.
Yeah, but sometimes he smells.
She'd be perfect.
Everyone all matched up?
Yes.
Where's Lily and Emma?
Huh?
Who are you asking to the dance?
We're not.
It's way more fun matching other people up.
Okay, so Zach likes alternative rock music, but not classical. And he likes to share everything.
Oh, yes, 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 yes. Perfect.
Perfect.
Okay, what are we gonna do with him?
Hello? I'm awake. Pink and purple? Yeah, they'll go great together.
It's past midnight.
I know. 5 more minutes, I'm almost done.
How many kids are there in your school?
A lot. But most of them are matched up now. I'm giving them advice on how to ask their match to the dance.
Can I try?
You're kidding.
I do this for a living, remember?
Well, yeah, but what you do is pretty much statistics. 40-year-old blonde guy, loves golfing, burritos, taking long walks on the beach, seeks 30-year-old woman. Pretty, blonde, weighing under 100 pounds. No kids, no pets. What Lily and I do goes so much deeper. I mean, we pay attention to every minor detail. We know our clients' hearts, and we make sure to treat them gently. I mean, what you do is pretty much clinical.
Thanks.
Sorry. I mean, your business serves its purpose.
Well, don't stay up too late. Good night. What about Emma's heart?
If it happens, you'll be the first to know.
Sorry, honey. The alarm didn't go off. What day is today?
Thursday.
I gotta call your father. Voicemail, typical. Daniel, it's Audrey. Just a reminder, we're switching girls tomorrow, so I'm gonna pick Emma up at the stable and drop Lily on the way home. Thank you.
I'm all packed.
Oh, you're such a good girl. Oh, come on. It's only a month. It's gonna go by fast.
It's not that. I mean, of course I'm gonna miss you. Mom, whatever happened with you and Dad? I mean, you used to be so in love.
Things change. People change.
I know. But don't you still love him, even a little bit?
I'm late, and you're gonna be late for school. We gotta get going.
So you took care of N through Z?
Hello?
I guess. You guess?
I got it.
Do you think Mom and Dad will get back together? I hope so.
You think he still loves her?
In his crazy, clueless, mix-up kind of way, yeah.
I don't think she loves him anymore. I mean, when she called him today to talk about the switch, she just acted so cold.
About the switch, do you care if I stay at Dad's? Just until Cassidy has her full. She needs me there. It's her first time.
Maybe Mom needs you too. Wait.
So, how about you tell me which girl's gonna take me to the dance?
Absolutely not.
That would just spoil all the fun. You have to wait, just like everyone else.
Okay, how about a hint?
Okay. It's a girl.
Leave me alone.
Stay away from Rita. Nobody messes with my girl. She's not your girl.
I've scuffed my shoes.
Hey, leave him alone.
Her what?
Nothing. Just leave him alone.
I don't like your face.
Who's that?
That's my cousin Connor. His family just moved here from back east.
So he's new? I mean, like, he goes to school here?
Yeah.
Cool.
You all right? Hey, Connor.
What are you doing?
No, smile.
Don't. So you're still making friends on the first day?
He had it coming. Just when you start talking to pretty girls.
You're funny, too. Connor, this is Lily, and this is...
Emma.
I'm Connor. It's nice meeting you both.
Okay, we gotta go. Let's go.
Bye, ladies.
Emma?
Hey, Dad. Dinner's ready.
I'll be upstairs in about an hour, okay?
An hour?
Are you kidding me?
Look, I'm sorry. I told you I was working late tonight, didn't I?
No, you didn't.
You forgot. Again.
Hey, you want to order pizza, pepperoni, your favorite? Hello?
Emma?
Yeah, I'm here.
I'll be upstairs in about an hour, okay?
Okay. Hey, Lil, can you come over? So where is he?
Downstairs, working.
As usual. Why the sad face?
I promised Daddy'd be the first to know, but Dad's not here, and you are. So,
I'm listening.
Okay, you have to promise not to tell a single soul what I'm about to tell you.
Okay, I promise.
It finally happened, Lily. I'm in love.
Well, I think I'm in love.
With who?
I can't tell you. Well, not yet. I want to ask him to the dance first. I mean, it'd be just my luck if he hated my guts or something.
So you called me all the way over here to tell me you're in love, which is probably the biggest thing that ever happened to you, and you won't even tell me who it is?
I'm sorry. Please don't be mad.
Well, you know how they say twins share everything?
I can't believe it. Both of us in love at the same time.
I know. Now I know how Juliet felt. Emma, do you get a weird feeling inside when he looks at you? I mean, like, you need to throw up, but you haven't eaten anything.
That's romantic. But,
yeah, I do. And when he smiles at you?
Uh-huh.
So it's agreed. As soon as they answer our invitation to the dance, we'll tell each other who we're in love with.
Agreed.
I can order pizza or we can go out to dinner. Do you want to go out for pizza?
Why don't you love Mom anymore? I mean, how do you just fall out of love?
It's complicated.
I'm listening.
I didn't fall out of love.
You still love her?
That's why it's complicated.
Why don't you just tell her?
So what is all this?
No fair changing the subject.
Wait, no fair asking too many questions. What are you doing with the shredder, young lady?
It finally happened, Dad. I think I'm in love. That's why I made a nice dinner for us. I wanted to tell you.
Sorry.
Now I know how you and Mom felt. It's awful.
Well, that's not the word that comes to mind when I think of love.
No, what I meant is I help other people fall in love. I mean, this kind of stuff just doesn't happen to me. I don't know how to handle it.
He plays ball?
Uh-huh. This is lame.
Oh, I think it's perfect. And I should know. So what do we got for dinner?
Well, you might find something in the sink.
Who's he gonna marry?
The hot blonde.
You think so?
I know so. Trust me, Lily. Men see with their eyes, not with their hearts.
But the other girl's so perfect.
It doesn't matter. He's gonna marry the hot blonde.
But how do you know?
Because men are shallow. And I have seen this movie before. You don't want to see the end?
Duh.
I guess I did kind of ruin it.
Do you want to help me with something in the kitchen?
Okay. But I want to take a quick shower first.
Just melt if you agreed to go to the dance with me.
Done already?
Sorry, I was in a hurry.
School project.
More like chemistry. Mom? I'm in love with a really cute guy.
Who is he?
I can't tell you yet.
So when can you tell me?
when he says yes to the dance.
So that's what this was all about, a school science project.
Technically, yes.
Oh. It's Emma.
Oh, she's in love too. But don't tell her I said anything.
Not a word. Lips are sealed. Hey, Emma.
Hey, looks like someone invited me to the dance.
Nope. I'm gonna text my mom and see if anyone dropped anything in my house.
No, please don't see me. Please don't see me. Please don't see me. Please don't see me. Please don't see me.
Did you hear that? There's something in there.
No way, another one. You're kidding me. Dude, I'm so jealous. Your heart is melting.
Huh?
No, I mean, it's really melting.
Oh. Nothing at your house? Anything?
No, Mom says she'd text if I got anything.
Man, that's too bad for you.
Did you do it?
Mm-hmm.
Did he see you?
No, but it was really close.
Oh, me too. There was a motion detector light and it popped on just as I was about to knock.
How long before they answer?
They're guys, Lily. It's gonna be a while.
I hope he says yes.
So what now? You got two invites, one guy. You do the math.
You get it.
If it's another one, it's mine.
Is this the Johnsons?
Oh, Johnsons are over there. Did you get invited?
No. Grandma came over, I have to go. It's the only thing I meant.
She's still cheating?
Yeah, you know it. Hey, whenever you make your decision, let me know, okay?
Yeah.
Said yes to Sarah, Alex said yes to Amanda, and Josh answered Melissa.
Jake has not responded to Sharon.
My date said yes, of course. Piper's date hasn't answered, and Ashley hasn't asked her date yet.
Why?
Because if he says no, I'll die.
No one ever says no.
That would be social suicide.
Hey, call me tonight, and I'll tell you a great way to ask him.
Thanks.
What if our guys say no?
They won't.
Thank you.
So you're not gonna tell me who asked you?
No.
Have you chosen who you're gonna take to the dance?
No.
We'll do it fast so the other girl can ask someone else. You wouldn't want to break her heart.
Did you girls get your dresses yet?
I did. I'm waiting. Just in case I chicken out.
If anyone gets the same dress as me, I'll freak out.
That happened to me last year.
Ugh, you poor thing. Lucky I don't have to buy off the rack.
Yeah, lucky.
Did you buy your dresses yet? Come on, you are going to the dance, aren't you?
Duh, Megan. They're the ones who make the matches. They get first pick.
I know that, Ashley. Thanks. Well?
Our mom's taking us tomorrow.
I can't believe we're looking for dresses.
I know.
I'm so excited.
Oh my gosh. It's perfect for me. Oh.
There's probably another one just like it.
We can't wear the same dress, Mom. So, how do I look?
Beautiful. Just beautiful.
It's gorgeous. Why don't you try it on, though?
That's okay. It was made for you. I like that yellow one over there.
You sure? Okay.
You're amazing.
It's about time.
Well, I answered.
So who's the lucky girl?
Both.
What?
Yeah.
Are you crazy? You answered yes to both of them. Why would you do that?
I don't know. I just did.
Well, who are they?
Yes. Yes, he said. Oh. Hello?
Emma.
He said yes.
When?
I don't know, just about a minute ago. Do you have anything?
Not yet. Hold on, let me go check again. Okay, I'm out front now. I don't see anything. Oh, let me go check the mailbox. There's nothing here. Lily, what if he doesn't answer?
He will.
I'll kill him if he doesn't.
It's on your face.
What?
Saving that for later.
Funny.
Why are you so sad?
It's nothing.
What's his name?
Oh, what fools these mortals be.
Macbeth?
Midsummer Night's Dream.
Wow, I'm impressed.
Yeah, I'm not just a handsome face. Someone left this near the gate. I think it's for you.
Dad, are you kidding me? Yes!
I told you,
I know, I'm so happy. It's like I'm seeing colors.
Me too.
So, tell me his name.
You first.
No, you.
Okay, we'll say on the count of three. One.
Two.
Three.
Connor Miller.
Hey, Mom, can I go to Emma's house?
Be back at 11.
Okay.
Is Emma okay?
Yeah, we just have a little mix-up we need to sort out. No big deal. Love you, Mom.
Love you.
They're exactly the same.
This is not happening. What are we gonna do?
We? There is no we. The girl who got their answer first should go to the dance. I got my answer first, so I'm gonna go.
That's not fair.
That's totally fair, and you know it.
So, what you're saying is that the girl who got her answer from Connor first gets to go to the dance with him?
Exactly. And that would be me.
We'll see about that.
Hey, Dad! Dad, 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 Dad.
Hey, girls.
Okay, remember that package you came for me today? What time did you get it?
I think the 6 o'clock news was coming on when I came through the door.
Aha!
Aha, what?
Try to focus. Dad put my answer in the kitchen at 6 o'clock. So technically, I got my answer first. Even though I didn't know it when you called.
Which was what time?
6:45.
Problem solved. Thanks, Dad.
Thanks a lot, Dad.
What?
You're the one that made up the rule.
You tricked me into it. Why don't you just ask Elliot out? He's the one that's totally in love with you.
Little problem, Emma. I'm not in love with Elliot. I'm in love with Connor, and I'm going to the dance with him.
In your dream.
In yours!
No way. Emma. And Lily.
Yeah.
Lily?
Yeah.
So have you figured out how you're gonna take both of them to the dance?
I'm working on it.
Can I sit here?
Audio? Everything okay?
No, not really.
Hey, Lily. Can I sit here? How's everything going?
You're the most beautiful girl I've ever seen.
Why thank you.
Those eyes. Drown those big blue eyes.
Did you like the baseball?
Yeah. I sleep with it under my pillow every night.
Really?
Soul. It's like a work of art.
Thank you.
The colors of your fingernails are so becoming. It's like love's brush just painted a canvas of beauty.
Wow.
Why do I feel like I'm the only one going crazy here?
I don't know, why?
Do you not see what you're doing?
No.
I've printed sides for you to audition with, and I have this clipboard you will need to sign if you're going to audition. I suggest you choose a partner to audition. It will be to your advantage to have a partner, and it will be to your advantage if you practice together often.
Hey, do you want to be partners?
He's not trying out.
Okay, we can be partners.
Cool. Weren't your fingernails purple before?
Were they?
Be sure to sign your name to the audition sheet. I'll expect you to be on time for the audition. 4 o'clock tomorrow, no second chances. You must be on time to be in my play.
I have to be Juliet.
Of course you do.
Hope I get to be Romeo.
You will. You're really good.
Better than Connor?
Lily, may I have a word?
Sure.
You have a natural talent, Lily.
Thanks. I really love the play.
I can tell. I don't usually do this, but I want to tell you I've got my eye on you for Juliet.
Really?
I see bright things in your future.
Thanks.
I'll see you at the audition tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Lily, hey, wait up. Hey, do you want to run lines tonight? Your house or mine? The play.
I can't. I'm busy tonight. Hey!
You can have him back in a minute. What is going on, ma'am?
What are you talking about?
You're playing both sisters.
I can't help it. I'm in love with both of them.
Hey, Ash.
Hey, Lily.
I just want to say thank you for helping me ask my
date. He's so cute.
You're welcome.
Where are you?
Home. Where are you?
We're at Connor's, at the get to know your date before the dance party that you and Emma
organized. You and Emma are so amazing. You pay attention to every little detail.
It's so romantic. You and Elliot should
totally come over.
Elliot?
You're taped for the dance, silly. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Wasn't I supposed to know?
Emma just told me. You two make a very cute couple.
Who exactly is there?
Oh, everyone, except you two. Emma and Connor are perfect together.
So are you coming?
I don't know, it's kind of late.
Well, we'll be here till at least midnight.
It's okay, I have other plans. But have a great time. Tell Emma hi for me.
Your hair. It's so long. It's like spun gold. It's so captivating. I think I'm in love with it.
It's just hair.
But it's your hair. If I can reach up and grab one of those stars, I'd bring it down here and give it to you. And do that.
Lily! I made a razzleberry pie. And there was this Cary Grant marathon on TV tonight. Your favorite.
If you don't mind, I'm really tired. I mean, I have my audition tomorrow and I need to polish my lines. I really can't blow this.
Oh. You are gonna be amazingly amazing. Hey. Have you been crying?
No. I'm just really stressed. You know how blotchy I get when I'm stressed.
Well, do you want me to DVR the rest?
Sure. I had a really nice time tonight.
Me too.
Let's wait.
As you wish.
Thank you. Good night.
Hey. Text me before you go to sleep.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi.
Audrey? What's wrong?
It's Lily.
What's the matter? Is she hurt?
Oh, no, nothing
like that. It's just that, when she got home last night, it looked like she had been crying.
Did anything happen over there?
She's a teenage girl. They cry all the time.
Not Lily.
No. She wasn't even here last night.
Are you sure?
I think I would know if my own daughter was at my house. Look, hold on a second. I really need to take this.
Don't even think about taking that call.
Hold on one second, okay?
Where were you?
I'm right on time. 5:00.
Auditions were at 4:00. I mean, you've known that for weeks.
No, I had a note on my fridge. Mrs. Porter. She didn't have an emergency, did she?
I see.
I see you got the part of Romeo.
Yeah.
Congrats.
Maybe if you talk to Miss Porter, she'll let you play the nurse.
I'll see you tomorrow. Hey, Megan. You got the part of Juliet? It's really cool. No, I'm really happy for you. I just, I think I'm coming down with something. You know, I gotta go. I think my dad's calling me. Okay, bye. Can't believe I did that to Lily. I'm a complete jerk.
Thank you.
would you do that to your poor sister?
Ask her what she did to me.
What did you do?
You started it. She drew all over my beautiful dress with a Sharpie.
Lily, do you know how much that dress cost?
I'll pay for it.
She sabotaged my audition.
Mrs. Porter...
She didn't have an emergency.
Oh, Emma, you know how much that role meant to your sister. How could you do that to her?
It's about that boy, isn't it?
We both love him. So we both asked him to the dance. And he said yes to both of us. Why would he do that?
And he's flirting with both of us, too.
But he likes me best.
I don't think so. Did he tell you that when he looks into your eyes, time stops?
No. But he said my freckles are like little angel kisses.
What?
Nothing.
Daniel, tell them why this boy loves them both so much.
What are you talking about?
Why is he in love with both of us?
Because you have a special gift, just like your dad does. Your dad is Cupid.
Cupid? Like the guy in diapers who goes around shooting bows and arrows at people?
Fine, just blurt it out. I thought we were gonna wait for the perfect moment to tell them.
Well, when is the perfect moment, Daniel? We were going to tell them when they were 13. Now they're almost going to college. When is the perfect moment?
You see, this is how you operate, isn't it? Blame everything on good old Daniel so you look like the good guy. Well, you know what? Take a good look in the mirror because you're the one that walked out. You're the one that split up this whole family. You know, good guys don't do that. No, good guys stick around and face the music like a man, like woman.
Oh, yeah? Well, this woman is done. This woman wants a divorce.
See how she gets?
So, do you think Mom's really serious about wanting a divorce?
You know how Mom gets when she's all worked up, especially about Dad.
Yeah, you're right. You need to do something.
Me? How?
I don't know. Lock her in a room until she comes to her senses.
I bet no one will notice if you put it up.
Practically bald.
Here, let me.
Why does love have to be so complicated?
Because that's what makes it exciting. Take Romeo and Juliet, for instance. If their families weren't feuding, their story would be boring. Romeo meets Juliet, they fall in love, get married, have kids, the end.
What's wrong with that?
Do you really think Dad is Cupid?
Yeah.
So, when I fell in love with your mother, that's when I crossed over, became mortal.
Did you use magic on Mom to make her fall in love with you?
No, she said it was love at first sight.
What about you?
I became mortal, didn't I?
So you can't make people fall in love anymore?
Apparently not.
Do you miss being Cupid?
Sometimes. It's a rush seeing people fall in love.
We know. What about falling in love yourself?
Well, that's where it gets complicated. I used to think I was the expert on love. I guess not. And take your mother, for example. I gave her this house, everything, and it wasn't enough. It was never enough.
Maybe she didn't want all this.
Maybe all she wanted was you.
Are you sad you're not Cupid anymore?
No. I'd do it all over again to have a moment with her.
If you still love her, why didn't you chase after her when she left?
She still loves you, Dad.
Well, then she needs to tell me that. If she's the one that left,
Emma or Lily?
I don't know. I've already told you that.
The dance is next week.
Well, can I just take them both?
No, you can't.
Why not?
Because girls don't share.
I feel like I'm under a spell or something. When I first saw Emma, I was like, she's the one. But then I saw Lily and I was like, wow.
You have to choose.
How?
I don't know, but if you don't do it soon, I'm gonna do it for you.
They'll never go for it.
Maybe not. But we have to try. We can't let Mom and Dad get a divorce.
Yeah, you're right. We'll do it tonight. I'll tell Dad I'm sleeping over at your house.
Okay.
I'm really, really, really sorry about your audition.
I'm sorry, too. About your hair, and the dress, and the... I'm just kidding. There's nothing else.
Here comes Connor.
Do I look okay?
Yeah, do I?
Hey.
Hi, Connor. Connor.
Have you guys seen Elliot?
Last I saw, he was at his locker.
Thanks. All right, well, I'll catch you two later.
Bye.
That was weird. He didn't even notice my hair. And he's not all...
besotted?
Yeah.
Let's just forget about Connor. You know, and concentrate on Mom and Dad.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go try to suck up to Mrs. Porter.
I could go with you and explain.
That's okay. You know, I better go alone.
Okay.
And about your dress? I used a washable marker.
See you tonight.
Bye.
Do you know who you are?
I am the messenger. This is my message.
Are you crying?
Me? No way.
Yes, you are.
It was the movie.
Mom, it was a movie about ninja assassins.
Well, ninjas have feelings too.
Why don't you just call him and tell him you're sorry and you really don't want a divorce? You know he's crazy about you.
I can't.
Why not?
Because I can't, okay? Just leave it at that.
I don't get it. You guys are grown-ups and you're acting like me and Emma. Dad still loves you.
Then why didn't he come after me after I left? He didn't even call.
You really think you can forge their handwriting?
I can try.
Dear Daniel, I'm sorry for acting like an idiot. It was all my fault. I was a complete fool.
It doesn't really sound like Mom.
No. Dear Daniel, can we talk? I can't sleep. I can't eat. I'm sorry for everything. Please forgive me.
It's perfect.
Okay, now Dad. Audrey, let's not waste any more time being mad at each other. I am so sorry for everything. I should have never let you go.
It's close. It's just not exactly the same. How did you do that?
I don't know.
Wow.
What else can we do?
Whoa. Watch this.
magic.
I know. This is awesome.
Maybe it's not as awesome as we think.
I mean, what if Connor didn't want to go to the dance with you?
Or me?
What if something we did made him fall in love with us?
Like Cupid's arrows.
Exactly.
And that's why he accepted both of our invitations to the dance.
Which means
we should focus on Mom and Dad and leave Connor until after they're back together.
You look amazingly amazing.
I do?
Mm-hmm. Huh? Where are you going?
Out. Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Emma, help me with my tie.
Wow, where are you going?
Out.
Out where?
Out there.
So, Dad, when you were Cupid, did weird things happen to you?
Like what?
Like things changing color and glitter shooting out of your fingertips? Because I think it's happening to me and Lily.
No, I never had glitter shooting at my fingertips.
No arrows?
Not like the movies or the greeting cards, no.
How'd you do it then?
It's hard to explain. I just kind of knew when people were meant to be together.
And then you made them fall in love?
Not made, helped. There's a difference.
Someone's coming. They're coming. Go, 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 go. Oh, the candles.
Check that out.
I'll get the music. Think we're getting the hang of this.
There's Mom.
Sweet.
He's late. Oh, wait, here he comes.
Sorry, I'm late. I got these for you.
Oh, another one?
Oops. They're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
I left my cell phone.
You did.
I've missed you.
I've missed you too. Dream about you last night. You were standing in the rain just like the first day we met. And I started walking towards you, but you turned and started walking away. So I called. But you wouldn't come back.
I'm here now.
It's just that it was one of those awful dreams that I couldn't wait to wake up. I'm talking too much, aren't I?
No, you're fine. I like hearing you talk. I missed your voice.
You have. I was so happy when I got your letter that you'd finally made the first move.
First move?
Your letter.
What letter?
The one that you said that everything was all your fault.
You sent me a letter.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. Hold on, let's talk.
There's nothing to talk about. Wait. I should have known that you would not have thought of something so beautiful. I was just a fool.
Come on, don't go. Please, don't walk away from me again.
How could you do that to me?
I just thought that...
You made me look like such an idiot. Jabbering on about my dream like a starry-eyed schoolgirl. The whole time, he's thinking I was the one who set everything up. I could just see his face when he got that letter, all smug and self-righteous, and stupid me, thinking that he finally cared enough to make the first move.
We just thought, we just wanted to help.
Trying to help? You made things a million times worse. How could that possibly help?
We thought that if we got you two together again, you'd make up, fall in love again.
Your matchmaking days are over, Emma. I want you both to stop. Stop with all this silliness. You're messing with people's lives, and it's just wrong. You know what the worst part is? The worst part is you made me hurt her all over again.
She flipped.
He freaked. She's crying. He's working.
Everything was so perfect until they figured out those letters were from us.
I know. They were both really going for it.
Mom looks so happy. I haven't seen her smile like that in a really long time.
They belong together, Lily. We need to show them that they're making a huge mistake. But how?
We could.
We can't. Dad said no more magic.
Then how are we going to make them fall in love again?
We can't make them. But we can help them. There's a difference.
What do you mean?
Dad said that when he was Cupid, he didn't make people fall in love. He just helped them.
Do you think that's why Connor stopped being so love-struck? The magic wore off?
Maybe. But like Dad said, we're supposed to help people make a connection. And if it is true love, it'll stick.
Okay then, we help Mom and Dad fall in love again. All we have to do is get them together one more time, and then it sticks.
And we do that how?
We'll think of something. We're Cupid's daughters, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
You're teaching yoga?
Uh-huh. It's good for the mind and the soul. You should try it. Look at this. That could work.
What's this?
Oh, nothing. They handed them out to everyone.
How it found its way to my desk. About last night.
It's okay. You were right. It was all our fault.
Do you want me to chaperone?
Oh, I'm sure other parents have already signed up.
But I want to.
Well, if you insist.
I do. Forgive me?
Of course.
Are you sure I won't embarrass you?
You're kidding. I mean, which girl wouldn't love to have their mom chaperone? Besides, I think I'll need you there for moral support.
Okay. Now, I'm sorry about last night. Can we just forget all about it?
Okay.
Give me a hug. Ooh, shh. Sorry, I think I put too much.
Looks like
we have everyone all matched up for tomorrow night.
So, we could share. You're kidding.
Here's what we'll do. We'll both get ready for the dance, and if he goes to your door, you go, and if he comes to mine, I'll go.
What about the girl who...
She deals with it.
No tears, no tantrums?
Exactly.
And no magic?
No magic. Because if it really is love, there will be magic.
But I wanted to take pictures.
You can take pictures at the dance. I think they need you there early. They have to go over some no-nos with you. Mm.
You look beautiful. Connor's a lucky guy.
Thanks.
Okay, now I won't ruin anything. See you soon.
Emma, could you help me?
Wow. Where did my little girl go?
She's still here.
You look beautiful. Just like your mother.
Thanks, Dad. You're gonna be late. I will see you at the dance.
Can't promise to save a dance for me?
I promise. Love you, Dad.
Love you too.
Shall we go?
You said that they were your favorite, just like your mom.
They are. They're beautiful. Thank you, Elliot.
I know I'm not Connor.
I know that, too.
But maybe I could be a good second best.
You're not second best.
Did it again.
Always playing matchmakers.
It's in their blood. Little girls are growing up.
It seems like only yesterday they were running around putting Valentine on everyone's front porch.
Why did you run away, Audrey?
Why didn't you come after me?
Thank you so much for doing this. We were afraid we wouldn't be able to find anyone. Don't just stand there. Mr. Valentine, ask your beautiful wife to dance.
Well,
No. I insist. I'll keep an eye on the students for you. Go ahead.
May I?
it that painful?
What?
Being close to me.
Oh, they're dancing. They look so cute. Oh, sorry.
No problem. He has two left feet anyway. You guys having fun?
Yes.
Elliot told me what happened with the audition. We talked to Mrs. Porter and asked if you and I could alternate playing Juliet. She said, yeah.
She did?
Mm-hmm. I'll see you Monday after school. Okay, don't be late.
I won't. Thanks, Megan.
No problem.
I just can't believe that I'm gonna be Juliet. And that you did that just for me. Thank you, Elliot.
But, Lily, I didn't do it for you.
You didn't?
No. I did it for me. I mean, how am I supposed to be Romeo unless you're Juliet?
What's wrong?
Nothing. I just feel bad for Lily.
You wish I'd chosen Lily instead?
No.
Look at her, she's happy. How much do I love being Emma? Count the waves.
Why are you still talking like that? I thought the magic wore off.
I don't think so. What you mean to me, you lift in me.
Counting the minutes to the music stops, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
I know you are.
Oh. Because you know everything. You know what I'm feeling, what I'm thinking. You know what I want.
What do you want, Audrey? And for the life of me, I can't figure it out.
I want.
Don't, please.
I want to go home.
I'll be right back. Come on, we have an emergency. It's Mon. Come on. What did you do this time?
What did I do? I didn't do anything.
Where's Mom?
She left.
And you let her go?
How could I stop her?
How could you not? Are you kidding me? You let her go off again? Are you sure you used to be Cupid?
It used to be so easy before I married her. All I had to do was make people happy. No questions asked.
All she wants is you, the way you used to be. That's all.
It can't be that simple.
It is, Dad, if you really love her.
Excuse me! Excuse me, I need that carrot. I need that carrot. Follow that woman, go!
They say you fall in love once in a lifetime. I mean, really in love. The kind where butterflies dance in your stomach and you're weak in the knees. What do you want?
I want you, Audrey. I've always wanted you.
But I say, you can fall in love over and over again. Until you get it right.
Look at this place.
Yeah, we just got here.
Of course I miss you.
Hey, I gotta go.
I love you too.
I can't believe it. Our first day at college. Freedom at last.
Yes, and with Mom and Dad off on their second honeymoon, they won't be able to check up on us.
They'll find a way.
I know.
So, how's Elliot?
He's gonna transfer here. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, awesome for you.
Oh, come on. Connor will be home for Christmas break, which is only in a few more months, and then it'll be just like old times.
We'll see.
Check it out.
Should we?
I think so.
Are you okay?
I am now.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
Oh, me too. Let's take a picture and send it to Mom and Dad.
Okay.
They took a long, hard, cold winter in stride.